I'm about to do a demo, but before I do the demo, in order to understand the demo, I need to introduce the difference between definite and indefinite integrals.
Yeah.
I know, I can hear the excitement. Good. So, we have what we've been doing all along are definite integrals. Definite integrals are integrals where there is a limit from time initial to time final, for example. That is a definite integral. I'm now going to introduce indefinite integrals, integrals without limits, and how we deal with that. So to start out understanding how we deal with that, remind me, what is the equation for instantaneous acceleration? Bill?
Instantaneous acceleration is equal to dv of dt.
As you recall, any derivative is also an integral, so we can rearrange this. We get dv equals acceleration times dt. We take the integral of both sides. Now, if we're doing an indefinite integral, that is, without limits, on the left-hand side, we're going to have the velocity as a function of time. And on the right-hand side, we're going to take the integral of acceleration as a function of time. Now, if we take the integral of acceleration as a function of time, we're going to get acceleration times t, because this is t to the zero power, plus c, where c is an unknown. And it turns out that c is the initial condition. And the way we can figure out what that is we set the time equal to zero. So the velocity at time t equals zero is the acceleration times zero plus c. So what is c in this particular case? Travis? That is the initial velocity, because v at time t equals zero is the initial velocity, that's equal to c. So we can then come back to this equation, which is the velocity as a function of time is equal to the acceleration times time plus the initial velocity. Or if you prefer, the final velocity equals the initial velocity plus acceleration times delta t. Which I think you've seen before. Okay, let's try again. What is the equation for instantaneous velocity? Henry? Just the equation for instantaneous velocity. Going all the way back to chapter 2 of college prep physics, only talking instantaneous versus average. Bring a little confidence into it. I'm sorry. Emily, help out. Derivative of position with respect to time. Again, we can rearrange it. We get dx equals velocity times dt. We can take the integral of both sides. On the left-hand side, we have the position as a function of time. On the right-hand side, we have the integral. Well, that's actually, the velocity as a function of time is the velocity initial plus the acceleration times time with respect to time. Right? Because this is just the velocity as a function of time. So I've replaced that with this equation. Okay, what then is the integral of velocity initial plus acceleration times time with respect to time? Gary?
Velocity final.
We need the integral of this. I agree this piece right here is the velocity final, but we're taking the integral.
Velocity final, or velocity initial squared plus.
But velocity initial is just a constant. It's not a variable. That's okay, he's not seeing it. Help him out here. Nitish?
Velocity initial times time.
Plus?
Acceleration times time squared over 2.
Plus c. We'll just leave c there for now. So the position as a function of time is equal to the velocity, sorry, that's an initial, velocity initial times time plus acceleration times time squared over 2 plus c. Okay, well let's figure out what c is. Well, the position at 0 is equal to velocity initial times 0 plus the acceleration over 2 times 0 squared plus c. Therefore, in this particular case, C is equal to what, John?
X initial.
The initial position. In other words, we have the initial position equals velocity, the final, or the position as a function of time, is equal to velocity initial times time, plus 1/2 acceleration times time squared, plus position initial. Or if you prefer, position final equals position initial, plus velocity initial times time, plus 1/2 acceleration times time squared. Which I think you've seen before.
Yeah.
Vlad.
How do you go from like x of t to xf?
Oh, it's because this is, by definition, this is the position at any time t, which is the same thing as your final position if you're talking about a specific time. So you'll notice, with calculus, all you need is the definition of acceleration and velocity instantaneous in order to figure out two of your UAM equations. And then the other ones are just rearranging those UAM equations together. All right, good. That is my introduction to indefinite integrals. We're now actually going to go through and do a demo.